Well, thank you for staying with us. It's the second part of the show. We were discussing the Africa Cup of Nations in Gabon when we went on the break, and we were already talking about the high number of goals already being scored in Group B. We can quickly report to you that another goal has been scored. This time, this has gone to Zimbabwe. So Zimbabwe are now trailing 2-4 to Tunisia. It's Tunisia 4, Zimbabwe 2. And that's the 10th goal scored in this group tonight. 10th goal in one night, in one group. Wow. I'm sure there'll still be a lot of goals before the end of the game.
Yeah, very true. And when you look at the style of play of all the teams, I think they are all attacking teams. You know, some may have conceded more than the other. Well, you look at the Teranga Lions of Senegal, right from their first game, they like scoring goals. Zimbabwe too, you know, have been very, very exciting, very adventurous. Yes, you might look at them as, you know, the underdogs, but I mean, they have really, really, you know, expressed themselves. So it's no surprise that goals are raining plenty, you know, from this group.
Mm. All right, let's talk about Group A. We spoke about Group A yesterday. How disappointed are you in the host? Because normally in a tournament like this in Africa, where travel is a big issue, and filling up the stands during international competitions like this are always a tough ask. Gabon's elimination, what do you make of Gabon's elimination?
Well, we see how the home fans will react to him. But I think it's not really good for them. Some people who like betting will say three straight draws.
Mm.
You know, they had the opportunity of winning that game, especially in the first half.
Look at this chance by Aubameyang.
I mean
that was a chance that made it quite
unpardonable to him. I mean, we are arguing in my office that these guys scores a lot of goals for Borussia Dortmund, but that one was a glorious chance, you know, for him to put his team ahead, but he missed that chance. We pray somehow that the organizers find a way of bringing the fans, you know, to the stadium. Now that the host team have, you know, crashed out, I mean, it will not be good for the tournament if you have empty venues, mm. you know, which is always the case when the host team, you know, exit from such a tournament.
Toby, look at this game. I'm sure you saw this game. This was the last chance that Gabon had and the last kick of the game.
Yeah, that was close for them. Kudos to the goalkeeper.
Double save.
I mean, yes. You know, double save for him, for Gabon, like Oya said. Not really good for them. No one expected them to get the goal in the group stage in a team where you have Burkina Faso and Cameroon. As it was, they could have a chance to get through to the next round. You know, one of those, you know, those that won't get to the next round since 1994 after Tunisia, you know, failed to get to the next stage. Not really good for them. Aubameyang was wasting the missed championship. Could have been really helpful for them in the final tour, but, you know, most time he missed some crucial, you know, opportunity for them, and if you don't convert the chances, you will always pay for it. And this really happened to Gabon. I mean, Burkina Faso, they really did everything to ensure that they are wasting the next round. You know, Cameroon, they got 5 points from three games, and for Gabon, they drew that all three games in the group stage. Not really, really good for them.
Cameroon are true, but Obi, I've been impressed with from the Nigerian perspective.
Yeah, not really.
But as I said, this thing will get better. Yeah, I think they will get better.
They will get better, you know. Hopefully for them, some players will make decisions to come back to the team, in as much as a lot of players rejected, you know, the opportunity to play at the AFCON. Some of these players might just make a return to the team before they play Nigeria. But I don't think there's anything to be scared of. Yes, decent team, 5 points from three games. They look very, very good. At least they really gain a lot of confidence. And, you know, going deep into the quarterfinals, they really want to play with high intensity and a lot of confidence. But I don't think Nigeria should get worried about this team, because we need to see how they put a different team against Nigeria, you know, come in August. But I don't think we should get worried about them. I think we have better players.
We can highlight some positives from the Cameroonian team. Their goalkeeper, for me, number one, is someone that makes this team. He has kept them in this competition. Look at the double save in the last minute against Gabon. Look at the saves in the previous games as well. So this is one player that we have to keep our eyes on as we prepare for the World Cup qualifiers in August.
So when you look at it in retrospect, I think it's in line with the tradition of Cameroon. They have always produced great goalkeepers, Thomas Nkono,
Antoine Bell, Jack Sungo.
Even the ageless Edis Kameni is still keeping very well in the Serie A, in the La Liga. So it's very much in line with their tradition. But I think the goalkeeper alone cannot make the team. Yes, he has done so well for this team. But we have to look at the team in its entirety.
This goalkeeper for me should be the captain of this team.
Yeah, very good goalkeeper in its entirety. And like Toby said, you remember that some players, you know, turned down the invitation to play in AFCON. Some of them might fancy, you know, the
coming back.
You know,
since the club will be on break.
Yeah, since they will be on window. FIFA window. And it's a bigger tournament. They will also want to be part of the qualifiers so that you'll be in a good position to make the World Cup team, you know, if they qualify, God forbid. But for me, I think we have to prepare very well, you know, because Cameroon playing Nigeria is always very, very tough. You know, no matter who's playing, they want to prove a point. And I think they have an edge in the sense that they have taken part in the tournament of this magnitude.
Well, that's a huge, lot of distance, a lot of months.
Yes,
playing January, February.
Yeah, what would the coach be thinking now? These young guns have made it to the quarterfinals. If they are able to do well and perform above expectation, they could probably be thinking, do I continue with these young guys and continue to build on what we have been able to achieve at the Nations Cup, or do I still leave the door open for the other guys who didn't show up to still come and have a feel of this team?
Well, I think it's always going to be difficult to change a winning team. If they go all out to win the championship, that means these players have proven themselves to be in the team. I mean, despite the fact that some players decided not to come. So, yeah, but the door will still be open to have one or two players, you know, depending on your opponent. You don't want to play Nigeria. You don't want to come with
a weakened team.
You want to have a full complement of your squad. But for the coaches, I think the coach will look at how this team will perform in this championship. Like I said, 5 points from three games is decent for them. If they get through to the next round, quarterfinal against Senegal, let's see how they could perform. If they knock that Senegal, that's big positive for them. But I really don't know. From January, February to August, there's a lot of, you know, distance in there. There will be injuries. There will be in and out of players. But hopefully, they won't be settled when they play Nigeria.
Let's keep that hope alive that they won't be settled. But let's also quickly tell you that at the Nations Cup, the quarterfinal fixtures are beginning to emerge with the conclusion of matches in Group A. Burkina Faso and Cameroon finished first and second in that group. And Burkina Faso will be waiting for the result of the game that's currently going on. And we told you, Senegal 2-2 with Algeria, Zimbabwe 2-4 to Tunisia. If it stays this way, it will be Burkina Faso against Tunisia. That's a mouth-watering quarterfinal fixture. And of course, the other one we already know is Senegal against Cameroon. That, for me, is a massive, massive game. It's a repeat of the final of the Nations Cup in 2002 in Mali that the Cameroonians won via penalty. All right, so we'll keep our eyes on the game that's currently going on. 65 minutes of football. The way it is at the moment, Zimbabwe will be picking Tunisia will be picking the second slot in Group B, and they'll be the one to face Burkina Faso in the quarterfinals.